The S-Class is the world's best-selling luxury sedan, and Mercedes-Benz claims that this new S-Class shows that they make the best automobile in the world. The S-Class is arriving at dealerships in Europe now, with North America and China arriving in the spring of 2021. The biggest changes are on the inside, and we'll get to that in a moment, but first of all, the design. This new S-Class is ever so slightly larger in every dimension compared to the previous car. Canada will again be getting a short and long wheelbase version of the S-Class. Previously, the United States only got the long wheelbase, so details on the US market have not been confirmed. The design certainly is recognizable, and Mercedes hasn't messed with a good thing. Many might not even notice the changes to the outside. It's the outside lines of this big sedan have been smoothed out, with less accent lines down the side. All the surfaces flow from one panel to the other and into the lights and trim, a very smooth surface overall. The idea was to have classic sedan proportions thanks to a short front overhang, a long wheelbase, and a balanced rear overhang. These flush-mounted door handles are standard equipment and are completely new. They electrically extend when the driver approaches or the outer surface of the door handle is stroked. One thing about S-Class, it's been quiet, and this new model is even quieter. The high rigidity of the body shell with items like the apertures for the cable grommets in the firewall now have double seals. To achieve an engine sound that is perceived as refined and unobstructive into the interior, the firewall insulation has been extended into the side area of the A-pillars and floor area. Mercedes-Benz is also using acoustic foam in certain body shell sections for the first time. There will be two engines offered. The base is called S500 with an inline six-cylinder turbocharged 3-liter with 429 horsepower and 383 pound-feet of torque, including electric boost from the 48-volt system. This is a short wheelbase model and will make a run to 100 kilometers an hour in 4.9 seconds. The larger, long-wheelbase model is called S580, and it has a 4-liter V8 with 496 horsepower and 516 pound-feet of torque. The 0 to 100 km/h run is unavailable at this time. Also, there is a plug-in hybrid model, but it's not being confirmed for the Canadian market. Okay, now on to the interior. The new S-Class can be experienced with all the senses, seeing, hearing, touching, and even smell. Mercedes says the focus is on the driver and the passengers with human-centered innovation. The S-Class uses the second-generation MBUX system with five screens on board, some with OLED technology. With the touch of a button, the new 3D driver display for the first time allows spatial perception of the scene with real 3D effect thanks to eye tracking. This feature is, of course, optional. The regular instrument cluster is a fully digital 12.3 inches. There's also a very large head-up display with augmented reality content. For example, when using navigation, animated turn arrows virtually project onto the lane in front. There's also the MBUX Interior Assist that recognizes and anticipates the intentions of the occupants. It does this by interpreting head directions, hand movements, and body language, and responds with corresponding vehicle functions. For example, if the driver looks over his or her shoulder towards the rear window, the interior assistant automatically opens the sunshade. The driver can even open and close the overhead sunshade by raising their hand. The real showstopper is the center screen, and worldwide there are two screens available. However, for the Canadian market, we get the larger of the two, which is 12.8 inches, and it's in portrait mode for more information. This system also is gesture sensitive, meaning the driver needs to only point at the desired feature. Using fingerprint technology, the car will activate the driver's desired settings, or the driver can ask the car by using Hey Mercedes.
Hey Mercedes.
How may I help you?
Please load my personal profile.
Okay, your profile is loading.
Now the animation on this screen looks similar to the existing MBUX cars, but it's just a larger screen. Now that voice assistant uses the connected data and artificial intelligence to get things you might need or even play games. It can be a bit gimmicky.
Hey Mercedes.
How may I help you?
How does an elephant sound like? Thank you.
There are also optional rear screens. The seat-mounted screen is available to interact with the car or use the same assistant. The rear passengers can use seat time to make a call routed just to the rear of the cabin, and they can even look things up, thanks to connectivity. There is also a central command screen to access seat and luxury controls. These are all optional. Now, it's got to be said, this cabin is absolutely stunning, with a level of refinement that one expects from this class of car. The interior almost looks yacht-inspired, with inlaid wood, polished surfaces, sumptuous seats, and fully adjustable lighting profiles all around, even special settings for each part of the car. There are even retractable tables, massaging reclining rear seats, and a fully automatic footrest are available. As mentioned, all the senses are covered, including the air balance package that provides an ionizer plus fragrance to set the mood. Mercedes also has what it calls 4D sound with 31 speakers, including speakers in the front headrest. These front headrest speakers help amplify information like navigation commands, phone calls, and more. This optional system has 1,750 watts and 37 channels that can each be tuned in the center MBUX system. Now, here are some extra features that you should know about. The new S-Class is available with E-Active Body Control, but this will not be available initially in the Canadian market. This feature is available in the current GLE, but will be deployed in the S-Class in 2022. What the system does is use a 48-volt electrical system to adjust the air suspension automatically using forward-facing cameras. The S-Class now comes with a rear steer option with up to 10 degrees of steering angle, helping to make this car much easier to maneuver. The standard air suspension can lower the car 17 millimeters at higher speeds and lift it by up to 30 millimeters. Handling is also improved thanks to a stiffer platform using more aluminum composite materials to reduce the body weight by 60 kilograms. For the very first time, there are new frontal airbags for rear seat passengers. These airbags are implemented into the rear of the front seats. They use compressed gas from a cold gas generator. These inflate at a slower rate than regular airbags, so child seats and small children are impacted differently. There's also an airbag between the front passengers to minimize side collision. This new center airbag is not yet available for the Canadian market. So, there it is, what Mercedes-Benz calls the most sophisticated car on the road, and a template of what's to come from the brand in other, less expensive models. What do you think? Are these new features welcome or maybe just a little bit gimmicky? Now, time will tell if a lot of these aids are actually more of a distraction or actually helpful. It's only going to take some seat time to find out. The design isn't really revolutionary, but the interior shows what Mercedes-Benz excels at, building first-class, comfortable cars. The S-Class goes on sale now in Europe and in North America next spring. So please subscribe to this channel for more virtual car releases, and thanks for watching the new S-Class virtual release.